The most isolated communities in the world. Palmerston Island. About 3,200 kilometers, 2,000 miles, northeast of New Zealand sits the tiny island of Palmerston. Occupied by a mere 62 people who are all from the same bloodline, Palmerston is one of the most isolated communities on the planet. The 62 inhabitants of the island can be traced back to just one person, William Marsters. As the first permanent inhabitant of the island, he took up residency there in 1863 with his Polynesian wife and her two cousins. After being granted possession of the island by Queen Victoria, Marsters took his wife's cousins as his second and third wives. He and his wives had 23 children in total. Before his death in 1899, Marsters separated the island into three parts and gave one part to each of his wives. Today, all but three of the people on the island are direct descendants of William Marsters. Life on the island is one of isolation and simplicity. There are no shops, banks, or markets. Money is only used when buying and selling off the island or when ships come with supplies from the outside world. Trade between islanders is the only way to get what you need. There is no true water system. Rainwater is collected for drinking, and there are two public toilets available on the main street. Electricity is only available for 6 hours each day. Supai Village, Arizona. The Grand Canyon is one of the most visited vacation spots in the United States. With its breathtaking views and desert-dwelling critters, the canyon provides tourists with an escape from reality. However, many do not know about the secluded village of Supai, which is located in a side branch of the Grand Canyon known as Havasu Canyon. The village consists of members of the Havasupai tribe. They have inhabited the area for the past 800 years. When the United States government began taking over the native lands in the 1800s, the Havasupai were unfortunately affected like so many other tribes. The village is located nearly 56 kilometers, 35 miles, from the tourist hub of the Grand Canyon, and there are no paved roads to get there. The journey starts at the Hualahai Hilltop. From this point, Supai can only be reached by foot, mule, or helicopter. It is 13 kilometers, 8 miles, one way to reach the bottom of the canyon where the village lies.